My name is Daryl Boyd. I am the head chef of the Edge Steakhouse at the Ritz-Carlton Rancho Mirage. And today I'm going to be walking you through our pickled mustard seeds that is one of the primary ingredients on our Benton's ham plate. Now, the reason I'm doing the pickled mustard seeds today is because most of us got tired of, during COVID, you see the chef demos and it's like, pull out the ostrich egg, pull out the dodo feather. They're going to do something that you're only going to use kind of once. So the main thing about these pickled mustard seeds is they will up your charcuterie game boards at your house whenever you're having guests over. They go great folded into salads. You can put them into dressings. You can kind of use them in a multiple of facets, and they last in your fridge for weeks and weeks and weeks because they're preserved at that point. So you don't have to worry about like, oh crap, is this going to go bad? So we're going to kind of get started today. And we'll have a little bit of TV magic because this is one of those things, it takes at least 30 minutes to kind of simmer, they're best if they're left overnight. So we'll go ahead and get those going, we'll have a TV magic, and then I'll kind of walk you through our Benton's ham plate and kind of the specialty of what that is. So what we do is we take our white wine vinegar, water, salt, and sugar, and we bring that to a boil. And we have this lovely click burner today, so it should take about a minute to kind of do that. While that's going, you would normally go ahead if you need to get your rest of your mise en place together. Today I'm doing a mix of yellow and brown mustard seeds. If you go to the grocery store and they only have brown mustard seeds or they only have yellow mustard seeds, you can use that. We go with both of them just so you have a nice little color. Now they will both cook at different times, so you may have to cook the yellows a little bit longer compared to the brown mustard seeds. So I wrote the recipe to go for the brown mustard seeds on the 30 minutes compared to the mix. So when you're kind of looking through your recipe that you get to take home, you'll know that that is based off of the brown, but like I said, both of them will work. So bringing that liquid up to a boil right now. And this is also, like I said, a great recipe that you can do days ahead of when you have guests coming. Almost to a boil. How's it going, everybody? So what I'm doing today is a pickled mustard seed, and it's going to be going on our Benton's ham plate, but this way you have a great recipe that you can take back to your house, you can put it on your charcuterie boards, you can put them in salads, dressings, things like that. It stores well, and it's something that you can easily get a hold of all the ingredients at a local grocery store, so that way you're not searching for that long-lost dodo feather that we talk about in the industry. So now that we've brought the liquids and the salt and the sugar and all of that to boil, you add your mustard seeds. Kind of give it a good stir. And at this point, this is kind of where the fun begins. You'll turn it down to a nice simmer, and you let it simmer for 30 minutes or so. Again, this recipe is based off of 100% brown mustard seed because they're usually easier to get. I do a mix of both the yellow and the brown for the restaurant because it gives us a nice little flavor, or it gives us a nice little color difference. So when you're going at home, if you need to adjust the time a little bit on that simmer, and it's best if it kind of sits overnight. So while these are kind of simmering, we'll do our TV magic commercial break. And I have some lovely pickled mustard seeds for you while these are working. So let me reach down to our cooler. And while I'm walking you through our ham plate and kind of some of that, we're still going to be keeping an eye on these mustard seeds. They're not going anywhere, but we all have busy lives. We all need to keep moving and doing things, so that's kind of what we're going to be doing. Let's see. So as you can kind of see, the mustard seeds are coming up to a boil. You're just gonna go ahead and give them a nice little stir and keep letting them simmer. on top of this little microwave oven over here, I have some brown butter. Just having it nice room temperature. That way it kind of stops congealing a little bit and it'll be for a drizzle. So what we're going to be building here is our Benton's ham plate that we have at the restaurant. So what is Benton's ham, you could ask? Benton's ham is a country ham out of Madisonville, Tennessee. So it is a small batch producer that I've gotten to meet Alan Benton a couple times coming from the South. And he does an absolutely gorgeous country ham. He does it in a prosciutto iberico style. So what we've done here is I've pretty much made a southern style carpaccio. So if you think about it, you go to the fancy restaurants, you get the nice super shaved thin beef tenderloin. It's gonna get drizzled with olive oil. It's gonna have Parmesan Reggiano on it. It's gonna have a little bit of extra Maldon salt put on top. So what I've done here is we start off with our nice little plate. We put 4 or 5 slices of Benton's ham on it. We then take, I use the nice Point Reyes tome, so keeping it kind of like a little bit of California. It's a great, nice, neutral cheese. Gives you a nice cream. And I'm just taking a little potato peeler, and we'll shave off a couple little slices. The kind of the fun thing about this plate is you just kind of let it fall where it lies. It's not going to be one of those precision plates of you have to put everything exactly in the same spot. You just kind of organize chaos, as I like to say, of let things kind of fall. So what I typically do is I do about 4 or 5 slices to go along with the 4 or 5 slices of that. Still keeping in mind our TV magic, we're working those mustard seeds still. Then we're adding for a nice crunch and salt texture. We have some Marcana almonds here. And again, kind of wherever they lie. This is gonna give you that nice salty, that nice crunchy. So you have your creamy, your salty, a little more salty. And this is where the part of the star comes in. Besides the Benton's ham for the Benton's ham plate, probably the best thing about it is the pickled mustard seeds. It adds a nice little pop of the actual mustard seeds. It adds some vinegar because if you think about it, this is a really rich dish. You're dealing with southern style country ham, you're dealing with cheese, you're dealing with salty nuts. Like this is one of those things, you need that nice little balance. So all I'm kind of doing is I'm adding a little bit of the mustard seeds in different spots on the plate. And then we'll have that brown butter will drizzle because nothing is quite finished, especially when you go out to eat without your garnishes. So one of the things I've always talked about also is no one's gonna eat a whole flower. It's just one of those things, you're not gonna bite it whenever you see it on a plate. I kind of laugh at it when some of my fellow chefs just put whole flowers. But what I like to do is I'll break the flower up. I'll add a couple of the leaves here and there. That gives you a nice little color to it. Add a little red vein sorrel, or hearts of fire, it's also called. A little more color, a little more leaves. And last but not least, because we talked about it being a southern style carpaccio, I'm not gonna drizzle it in olive oil. That doesn't really make sense. I come from the South. We like our butter, we like our dairy, we like our chicken, we like our salted meats. So what we have here is a brown butter I did, and it just gets lightly drizzled over the top, and that's gonna add a nice little nuttiness and a little more richness to it. So this is our Benton's ham plate. And this is one of our apps we have here at the Edge Steakhouse, and it's a great way to kind of use those pickled mustard seeds that, like I said, they're still kind of working. And it's one of those things, these go great in salad dressings and all types of different things. So we'll have those. After about 30 minutes of simmering, we add our shallot. Obviously, we're kind of speeding things up a little. Give them a good stir. And you let those simmer and go overnight. Any questions? Perfect. Thank y'all so much. And I think there should be some samples coming. Looking for the sample people, because nothing's complete without actually getting to eat a bunch of ham and cheese and mustard seeds and almonds. Yes. So I have a couple of dishes. This is probably one of my favorites because it obviously it reminds me of my time in the South. But probably one of the showstopper dishes I consider is we have a little bit over a pound pork shank that we're braising in mole served on Anson Mills grits with preserved lemon and a nice gremolata. So you're getting that richness, that chocolatiness, and I'm a Southern boy at heart, and I think you can put grits on anything, so it gives you that nice little corn base and richness. Anything else? Perfect. Thank you all so much.